So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the channel. And guys, in today's session we are going to discuss about the major recommendations of the France Commission report for the year 2021 to 2026. Alright, so let's begin with the session guys. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. And also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions, and you can also ask any doubts here. Alright, so let's begin with the session and let's first of all try to understand the basics of the Finance Commission. So as we all know, Finance Commission guys is a constitutional body that is set up every 5 years by the President of India under Article 280 of the Constitution of India. Alright, so you should remember this article, Article 280 of the Constitution of India. Uske andar har 5 saal ke liye Finance Commission set up kiya jata hai by the President of India. Remember this, it is set up every 5 years by the President of India. And there are 3 key responsibilities of the Finance Commission. 3 main responsibilities of Finance Commission ki, which are: number 1 is to recommend the distribution of proceeds of taxes between the Union and the States. Union or States ke beech mein jo taxes ka proceeds hoga usko distribute karna aur uske liye recommendation dena. Then to recommend the principle which should governs the grants in aid that are given to the states. Jo states ko grants in aid diye jate hain, uske liye kya kya principles follow kiye jayenge, uske recommendation dena. And third, to recommend on any other matter that is referred to the commission by the president which is required for the public finance. Okay, jo ki public finance ke liye, public finance ke liye जो भी चीजें इंपॉर्टेंट हैं उसके लिए राष्ट्रपति अगर उनको रिकमेंड करता है फाइनेंस कमीशन को, सो टू रिकमेंड इन दैट मैटर्स आल्सो. सो दीज आर द 3 की रिस्पांसिबिलिटीज ऑफ द फाइनेंस कमीशन. एंड रिमेंबर द 15th फाइनेंस कमीशन वाज सेट अप बाय प्रेसिडेंट इन द ईयर 2017. एंड ऑफ कोर्स हु इज द चेयरपर्सन, इट्स मिस्टर एन के सिंह. एंड इट्स रिकमेंडेशन आर फॉर द पीरियड ऑफ फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2022 टू द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2026. ऑलराइट, एंड मूविंग अहेड to the 15th Finance Commission report. So it is divided into 4 volumes. 4 volumes mein divided hai. Volume 1 and volume 2 consist of main report and annexes, while volume 3 is devoted to the union government only, and volume 4 is devoted to the states only. So you should remember volume 1 and 2, main report and annexes, volume 3 devoted to the union government, while volume 4 is devoted to the states. And total there are 117 core recommendations in the report. Total kitni hai? 117 core recommendations are report mein. And of course 117 recommendations yaad karne ki koi zarurat nahi hai, you just have to remember the major recommendations. Alright, so now let's talk about the recommendation, and guys we will do this in the form of question. First of all I'll bring to you a question, and then us question mein jis cheez ki bhi baat hogi we will discuss about that. Alright, so question number 1 is what? As per the 15th Finance Commission recommendation, central government should bring down the fiscal deficit to what percent by the year 2025-26? That is the financial year 2026 tak central government ko apna fiscal deficit kitna kam lena kar lena chahiye as recommended by the 15th Finance Commission. So let's talk about this fiscal deficit ki baat kare. So the 15th Finance Commission guys has recommended that the central government should bring down the fiscal deficit to 4% of the GDP by the financial year 2026. फाइनेंशियल 2026 तक हमें अपने फिस्कल डेफिसिट को 4% ऑफ द जीडीपी तक लेके आना चाहिए, ऐसा रिकमेंड किया है फाइनेंस कमीशन ने. एंड ऑल्सो फॉर स्टेट द कमीशन हैज रिकमेंडेड दैट द फिस्कल डेफिसिट एज द परसेंटेज ऑफ देयर ग्रॉस स्टेट जीडीपी. ओके, जो उनका ग्रॉस स्टेट जीडीपी है उनके परसेंटेज के हिसाब से 4% इन द फाइनेंशियल 2022, 3.5% इन फाइनेंशियल 2023, एंड for 2023 to 26 it is recommended 3%. कितना recommend किया गया? 3% fiscal deficit of the GSDP. Alright, and इसके अलावा extra annual borrowings worth 0.5% of GDP will be allowed to the states. जो states हैं उनको extra annual borrowing allow की है, कितनी? 0.5% of the state GDP. For what? For following the power sector reforms. अगर वो power sector reform में कुछ काम करेंगे तो उनको 4 सालों के लिए, that is for the year 2021 to 25, they are allowed for extra annual borrowings of 0.5% of their GDP. Alright, so these are some recommendations by the Finance Commission regarding the fiscal deficit. And now I hope you can easily answer this question. So the question was, as per the Finance Commission recommendation, central government should bring down the fiscal deficit to what percent? So the central government guys should bring down the fiscal deficit to 4%. So option D, 4% here should be the correct answer. Alright, And now let's move ahead to question number 2. How much share has been recommended by the 15th Finance Commission for states from the central taxes for the year 2021 to 26 period? पूरे रिकमेंडेशन पीरियड में जो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट है वो स्टेट को कितना परसेंट टैक्स देगी बेसिकली. एंड दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. जनरली एग्जाम में जो क्वेश्चन आता है फाइनेंस कमीशन से उसमें ये वाला क्वेश्चन जरूर होता है. राइट, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वर्टिकल डिवोल्यूशन फर्स्ट. नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ वर्टिकल डिवोल्यूशन? सो डिवोल्यूशन ऑफ टैक्सेस फ्रॉम सेंटर टू स्टेट्स. जो सेंटर से स्टेट्स को टैक्सेस जाएगा दैट इज नोन एज वर्टिकल डिवोल्यूशन. वाइल हॉरिजॉन्टल डिवोल्यूशन मतलब एलोकेशन बिटवीन द स्टेट्स. राइट, सो फॉर वर्टिकल डेवल्यूशन द फाइनेंस कमीशन हैज रिकमेंडेड द वर्टिकल डेवल्यूशन एट हाउ मच परसेंटेज? 41%. ओके, एंड द एक्सपेक्टेड ग्रॉस टैक्स रिवेन्यू इज हाउ मच? रुपीज 132.5 लाख करोड़. यू शुड रिमेंबर दिस. जो एक्सपेक्टेड ग्रॉस टैक्स रिवेन्यू है वो कितना है? 132.5 लाख करोड़. एंड ऑल्सो द स्टेट्स शेयर एट 41% ऑफ डिविजिबल पूल कम्स टू कितना? 42.2 लाख करोड़ हो जाएगा. टोटल कितना है टैक्स का जो रिवेन्यू होगा? दैट विल बी हाउ मच? 132.5 लाख करोड़. और उसमें जो स्टेट का वर्टिकल डेवल्यूशन 41% वाला हटा देंगे तो इट विल कम आउट हाउ मच? 42.2 लाख करोड़ फॉर द ईयर 2021 to 2026. राइट, एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द हॉरिजॉन्टल डेवल्यूशन. सो फॉर हॉरिजॉन्टल डेवल्यूशन देर आर सम क्राइटेरिया. कुछ क्राइटेरिया है जैसे कि पॉपुलेशन का कितना परसेंटेज है? दैट्स 15%. एंड फॉर एवरी क्राइटेरिया देर इज अ परसेंटेज, देर इज इट्स वेटेज. ओके, population it is 15%, area it is again 15%, forest and ecology 10%, income distance it is 45%. Now what is this income distance? Income distance, guys, it is basically the gap between the state GDP of a particular state with respect to the state with the highest GDP. okay, ye gap hota hai kis kis ke beech mein, ek particular state jiski hum baat kar rahe hain uski GDP aur dusra state jiski GDP sabse zyada hai. all right, सो उसका परसेंटेज सबसे ज्यादा है 45%. टैक्स एंड फिस्कल एफर्ट्स इट इज 2.5% ओनली. एंड फॉर द डेमोग्राफिक परफॉर्मेंस इट इज 12.5%. सो यू शुड रिमेंबर ऑल दीज परसेंटेज ऑफ वेटेजेस एंड ऑल दीज क्राइटेरिया जिसके ऊपर हॉरिजॉन्टल डेवल्यूशन बेस्ड है. एंड रिमेंबर व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ हॉरिजॉन्टल डेवल्यूशन? इट्स एलोकेशन ऑफ टैक्सेस बिटवीन द स्टेट्स. ऑलराइट, so now I hope you can easily answer this question. Question number 2, how much share has been recommended by 15th Finance Commission for states from the central taxes? So it's 41%. Option A, 41% is the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 3. What is the amount that has been recommended by 15th Finance Commission for agricultural reforms and aspirational districts and blocks respectively? एग्रीकल्चरल रिफॉर्म्स के लिए और एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स और ब्लॉक्स के डेवलपमेंट के लिए कितना अमाउंट रिकमेंड किया गया है फाइनेंस कमीशन द्वारा? सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस. सो फॉर एग्रीकल्चरल रिफॉर्म्स ₹45,000 करोड़. हाउ मच? ₹45,000 करोड़ हैज बिन रिकमेंडेड बाय द फाइनेंस कमीशन फॉर वॉट? फॉर परफॉर्मेंस बेस्ड इंसेंटिव फॉर ऑल द स्टेट्स इन द फील्ड ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरल रिफॉर्म्स. अगर कोई स्टेट एग्रीकल्चरल रिफॉर्म करता है तो उसमें परफॉर्मेंस बेस्ड इंसेंटिव दिया जाएगा और उसके लिए टोटल अमाउंट जो रिकमेंड किया है फाइनेंस कमीशन ने दैट इज हाउ मच? ₹45,000 करोड़. ऑलराइट, एंड व्हाट अबाउट एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स एंड ब्लॉक्स? सो फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स एंड ब्लॉक्स टोटल ₹3,150 करोड़ हैज बीन रिकमेंडेड बाय द फाइनेंस कमीशन फॉर देयर डेवलपमेंट. ऑलराइट, सो देयरफॉर गाइस द करेक्ट आंसर शुड बी व्हाट वी हैव टू टेल? एग्रीकल्चरल रिफॉर्म्स एंड एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट. सो इट इज 45,000 करोड़ एंड 3,150 करोड़. ऑप्शन बी should be the correct answer. All right, and now let's move ahead to question number 4. Question number 4 says, consider the following statements regarding the recommendation of the 15th Finance Commission regarding education and health, and you have to identify the correct statement. So education or health ke sector mein Finance Commission ne jo bhi recommendation di hai uske regarding you have to identify the correct statement out of these three. All right, so let's talk about the health sector first. Sabse pehle health sector ki baat karte hain. So the commission recommended, commission ne ye bola hai that the health spending by the state should be increased to more than 8% of their budget. The health expenditure of all the states should be increased to more than 8% of their budget by the year 2022. 2022 tak unka jo percentage hai 8% se zyada hona chahiye. And also it has recommended that the public expenditure on health should be increased to 2.5% of GDP by the year 2025. 2025 तक 2.5% ऑफ द जीडीपी हो जाना चाहिए. ओनली देन वी विल बी एबल टू प्रोवाइड बेटर हेल्थ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर टू आवर सिटीजंस. एंड प्राइमरी हेल्थ केयर एक्सपेंडिचर शुड बी 2/3 ऑफ द टोटल हेल्थ एक्सपेंडिचर बाय 2022. एंड द टोटल रिकमेंडेड आउटले फॉर ऑल ऑफ दीज is how much? Rupees 106,606 crore. So you should remember this amount also. 106,606 crore for the health sector. All right. And moving ahead to the education sector. So the commission has recommended a grant of rupees 4,800 crores. Okay. 4,800 crores, 1,200 crore per year for a period of 2020-23 to 2025-26, which means financial year 2023 to financial year 2026. Now this grant has been recommended for what? For what purpose? So it is for incentivizing the states for enhancing their educational outcomes. Taki jo states hai, wo apne educational outcomes ko enhance kare, and jo central government hai, they will incentivize them by providing them with these grants, and the total outlay is how much? Rupees 4,800 crores. Okay. And the commission has recommended 6,143 crores for online learning and development of professional courses in regional languages in the higher education. Higher education mein, regional languages mein, professional courses ko develop karne ke liye 6,143 crores rupees has been recommended by the finance commission. All right. So this is about the education and health, and now let's come back to this question. The commission recommended that the health spending by the states should be increased to more than 8% of their budget by 2022. This is absolutely correct. Finance commission ne recommend kiya hai ye. And the public expenditure on health should be increased to 2.5% of the GDP by 2025. This is also correct. And rupees 6,800 crore has been sanctioned for incentivize the states for enhancing their educational outcomes. No guys, is that 6,800 crores? It is 4,800 crores, which means this statement is incorrect. And we have to identify the correct statement. Therefore, option C, only 1 and 2 guys should be the correct answer here. I hope this question is clear. And now let's move ahead to question number 5, which is again a very important question. How much corpus has been suggested by the 15th Finance Commission for Modernization Fund for Defense and Industrial Internal Security for 5 years till 2026? So, ye ek modernization fund banega for defense and internal security. Iske liye kuch fund allocate, iske liye kuch fund recommend kiya hai Finance Commission ne. So, the question is about that, and you should remember, so for this fund, total 2,38,354 crores should be there. 2,38,354 crores has been recommended by the Finance Commission, which is approximately 2.4 lakh crores. Remember this also, which is approximately how much? 2.4 lakh crores. So, 2,38,354 crores has been recommended for setting up of this fund, which is known as Modernization Fund for Defense and Internal Security. Okay, so I hope you can easily answer this question now. So the correct answer to this question is what? Option B, approximately 2.4 lakh crores, 238,354 crores, which is approximately 2.4 lakh crores. Okay, so option B here is the correct answer. And now let's talk about some other recommendations of the Finance Commission. For example, revenue deficit grant kitna hai? Revenue deficit grant has been recommended how much? 2,94,514 crores for 17 states. 17 states ke liye revenue deficit ko khatam karne ke liye kitna grant diya hai? 2,94,514 crores 17 states ke liye. And also for the local governments, the total grants which has been recommended by the Finance Commission is how much? Rupees 4,36,361 crores. अगर ये याद रहता है तो ठीक है, अदरवाइज देयर इज नो इशू. लोकल गवर्नमेंट वाला इतना इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है, बट अगर याद हो जाता है देन दैट इज वेरी गुड. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द डिजास्टर रिस्क मैनेजमेंट, सो फॉर स्टेट डिजास्टर रिस्पांस मैनेजमेंट फंड, फॉर स्टेट डिजास्टर रिस्पांस मैनेजमेंट फंड हाउ मच अमाउंट हैज बीन रिकमेंडेड? इट इज रुपीज 1,60,153 करोड़ फॉर स्टेट फॉर डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट फॉर दिस पीरियड ऑफ 2021 टू 2026. एंड ऑल्सो आउट ऑफ दिस 160,153 crores, the union share will be how much? 122,601 crores, while the state's share will be how much? 37,552 crores. So isme bhi amount, ye jo union ka share hai aur jo state ka share hai, agar ye yaad hota hai then that is fine, otherwise there is no issue. Just remember that for the state disaster response management fund, rupees 1,60,153 crores has been recommended by the 15th Finance Commission, which is chaired by Mr. N.K. Singh. All right. So guys, that's it for the session. These are some major recommendations of the Finance Commission. And of course, the Finance Commission report is very, very important for all your exam. So thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.